quick review on the Abu Garcia Abumatic 276i. Now, I got this for little Miss Muffet because she wants to start fishing. And I have several Abu Garcia reels and rods. In fact, I have my Okuma reel, my Okuma Fina. It's the Okuma Fina FH-S30 reel. I have it on an Abu Garcia 3-star action rod. And I like the rod a lot. I didn't see an Abu Garcia rod at Walmart. So what I did was I bought this Shakespeare Durango rod for $10.99. And I'm just going to try it out on this. Okay, we're just going to throw a split shot on here and a real small hook, because we're going to run down to the pond. We're going to use this Magic Bait Crappie Bites again, and we're going to throw out this rod. I think I'll take a floater as well. Okay, my pond don't look too good this year. But we're going to try this Abu Garcia rod and reel. I always use a different rod. You know those combos you buy at Walmart, the rod and reels? I've only bought a few, and I've always switched the rods out if I've liked the reels. And sometimes I bought them for the rods and not the reels, and sometimes I bought them for the reels and not the rods. But you do by far a lot better, in my opinion, now, if you buy the reel separately and the rod separately. Because you're gonna have to find a rod that you like, the size, the weight, the feel. And it, on those combos, it's not always the best of either one. Sometimes it's a good deal though, especially if you want to get out on the water, or if you've broke your rod. I bought that Zepco 33 with that long 7-foot rod for $25 at a little convenience store one day because I slammed my rod in the door, and it was actually an Abu Garcia reel, and the little handle came off on the reel as well, so I had to go buy one. But I tried to stay away from the combos. Alright, we're going to try this. I set the drag a little bit, and we're going to see how well it does right out of the box. Well, it's a smooth cast. We're going to do that again. Make sure that the camera's getting it. It was definitely a very, very smooth cast. And it's got a really nice placement of the button as well. See, I have a couple Abu Garcias, and the button's on this side. And you get pushed down, and it's not... I'm actually getting rid of them. They're not my favorite location for the button, but that is some smooth action there. All right, we out there. We getting a couple nibbles. Let's see if we can't hook something real quick. Got something that time. I don't think it's very big, but this reel's got a really, really smooth action. Look, that's just a small... You know what? I kind of think that's a bass. I'm not sure that's a perch, but... Yeah, it's a bluegill. That's a little bluegill. Let's see if we can't get something else. Something a little bit bigger. You know this, the line, the stock line that comes on it, it's the Berkeley Tri Line. It's the 8 pound. I really don't think I'm too fond of it. It's you know, it's almost as thin as my 2 and my 4 pound line, and it really likes to tangle around itself. I can tell you, the only drawback on this reel is the line. It's a fight and it's a battle not to get it tangled. So, first thing we're going to do when we get up there, back to the house, is we're going to strip that line off. And you know, they only had it half spool. We're going to strip that line off, and we're going to put different line on it. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go up and we're going to despool this line. I'm getting another bite. All I'm catching is little tiny perch. We're going to go up and despool this. We are going to put, I do have some spider wire 10 pound, but I think I'm going to go with that 12 pound green that's on my Akuma. Now, what I do is I push the button, and right now I got a popsicle stick in there, but you could take an old pin, anything in your cordless drill, just put it in there, because I'm just going to throw it away. And I'm just going to wrap this about 5 times. Sometimes I tape it, sometimes I just wrap it. We're just going to wrap it. And then they just despool it. It'll sit there, we'll take all the line out. Just make sure your button is put. It's Abu Garcia. Hope that button stays down. Yeah, the button will stay down. It'll stay down. You just hold it and despool the whole reel. Okay, I had to switch. The popsicle stick broke, but I put a pencil in there. When you get to the end, it'll pull the rod up, and you just snip, and you'll have to snip it off the inside as well. What I got for that is, now, I don't see it. Probably can do it with these scissors. I had a little tiny pair of scissors. They're in my tackle box, I reckon. Let me just put my glasses on. Alright, so now we're going to spool this on. We're going to use that Berkeley mini spooler. You'll see that video on my YouTube. And yes, I use the little washers. Somebody got on my YouTube page and said, I got the same mini spooler, and you don't need them washers. That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. Well, you know what? I have, 40 poles? We fish 3-4 times a week. I despool and spool a lot of line, and I need the washers. So who cares whether you need them, don't need them or not, but you need to get on a video. I removed the video, or removed the comment. I got one of them little washers that have the grooves in it, and then another washer, and believe it or not, it works perfect for all the different size spools, and to put the right amount of tension so that you're not spooling behind the spool. And the little mini spooler will do exactly that. It'll spool. Let's see which one I need to put in. It'll spool behind the
spool. So I don't care whether or not you like my little washers. I put that idea out there for someone that might be having a little trouble with different size spools. I have all kinds of sizes of spools. I got the big ones from this size. I go all the way down to this size. And I'm going to tell you right now, when you go to this size, there is no room left to see this little groove in there? There is no room left to get it tightened as tight as you need. You need to have those washers. Now, maybe it's just me. Maybe the guy's right. But for someone who said they had it and it works fine without it, why were they on my video watching me how I do it? How I spool with the mini spooler. Why were they on there? Yeah, well, who knows? Who knows? You can't figure out some of these trolls that are on YouTube and all the other Twitters and Facebook and stuff. There's some serious trolls out there. That's what, when you have your video up, that's what remove that comment is for. This puts a little bit of better control into this plastic little handle. Otherwise, if you don't have those washers there, that little piece of plastic handle goes into this little thing and it doesn't have enough tension and it allows you to spool on the back side. It's just a pain in the rear end. But if you just put a couple washers there, especially if you have that grooved one, it solves all of that issue. And then you can put the tension you want on it. It solves that issue. So let's spool 12-pound Trilene low visibility green Trilene XL 12-pound on this. Oh, okay. It says right on the top. Didn't see it down there at the pond. It says you can spool 6-pound, 8-pound, 10-pound, 15-pound, 20-pound, 25-pound. So it's not just... See, I was looking for it here. Usually it's around the side. I didn't look on the top. So they recommend you can go all the way up to 25-pound. So my 12-pound is going to be perfect. You'll see. I'm telling you, I love this line. I've tried all the lines out there. All of them. You know, I'm 49 years old. I've tried plenty of fishing line in my years. So anyway, tie my little knot in the end. Now let's get this thing re-spooled and get down to the pond and see how much better it'll do. Those washers make it a lot better. It don't come off and go behind the spool. Okay, we all set. We got it all rigged back up with a split strap, with a hook floater, the 12-pound Berkley Trilene XL smooth casting low visibility green, which I like. It's my favorite line. And I think it's going to be pretty smooth. So let's run down to the pond again. And we're going to try this out. And I'm pretty sure that you're going to agree with me that that stock line, even though it's Berkley and it's Trilene, it's that 8-pound monofilament, I reckon. I'm not too fond of it.
Okay, I can already tell that this line is going to be a lot better. So we'll see. It casts just fine. So now we're going to try the Uncle Josh floating trout nuggets. You can get at Walmart for $2.96. Let's read this side. Did I bring my glasses? Yeah. Let's read this side and see what it says. Cover hook with trout nugget, cast catchfish. So easy with the floating moldable trout nugget, original trout hatchery food, glitter effect, and original flavors. Amino acids, trout hatchery food, natural scents, glitter, fish attractant. Uncle Josh Bait Company, Fort Atkinson, Wisconsin. Oh, and they put not for human consumption. Yeah, you know. It's good enough for fish. It's good enough for us, right? Don't you think? If it's good enough for them to eat, why can't we eat it? Somebody's probably eating a nugget right now, ain't they? Alright, so we're gonna put this on our hook. We're just gonna stick it on there. Let's press it around that hook a little bit. And we're going to throw it out there and see what we get. See if there's anything wants that trout nugget. I am pretty sure there are no trout in this pond. I think they're mainly pumpkin seed perch and some bluegill. Oh, I think we got something here. Look at that. You know what? Isn't that something? I didn't even know there were bass in this pond. I didn't even know there were bass in my other pond. That's one of the Roanoke bass, I believe, from the other pond. You know, I think a couple years ago I did move some around. That is a... I think that's my Roanoke bass that we stocked the other pond. The other pond was stocked with. She's a gorgeous fish, isn't she? So, I'm telling you, that's a better feel on that... On that line too. I'm not even sure I can get close to the there's a big drop off here. So guess what I caught that one on? I caught that on the Uncle Josh's floating trout nuggets. They're $2 and something. I think they're $2.96 at Walmart. So that's what we used that time. And we caught a nice little bass. You know, that wasn't a bad size bass. You got to understand something. I'm 235 pounds and my hands is twice the size of someone that's 5'10 and 150 pounds. I'm 6 foot, 235 pounds. So my hands are a little bit bigger. So when you see these fish, I need to be bringing a ruler with me. They're a little bigger than you might think. That was a nice size one. I mean, that was pretty decent. I guess that's about 8 ounces. 8 or 9 ounce fish. I tried those trout nuggets the other day on my neighbor's pond. And didn't catch anything. You know, I have never caught a bass on this pond. This is our other pond, which is on... If you see any of my farming videos, you'll know that the other pond's on the other side of the house. That's the bass pond. This is the perch pond. And I've transferred fish so many times back and forth between the ponds. I probably threw a couple of those Roanoke bass over here. My neighbor across the way used to live across the way. Nobody lives there now. Said he found catfish in the his field. So apparently, way back when, someone put some catfish in that pond. But I have yet to catch a catfish on that other pond. And there's trout in that pond too. And I have yet to catch a trout in that pond. But I've caught Roanoke bass in that pond, and I've caught perch in that other pond. But I've only caught perch in this pond. I didn't even know there was a bass in here.